New satellite images over Lake Okeechobee show a significant reduction in the amount of blue-green algae on the surface. On the left, you see here, May 11th. Look at all those colors. You can see 500 square miles of the lake covered in muck. That's 68% of the surface. Well, today, a much different picture. This is equal to, still equal, it's only 150 square miles of lake covered, but that's equal to about four Sanibel Islands covered in algae. There is still algae in the Caloosahatchee as well. Health alerts are still in place at several boat ramps in Lee County because of the slime.
As for red tide, there have been several fish kills reported just in the last 2 days, from Carlos Point Beach in Estero to a canal in Cape Coral. Now we are seeing more than just marine life affected. NBC2's Alex Howard found out animal clinics are seeing a huge influx of birds sickened by red tide.
Well, and experts say the birds being brought into places like Crow and Audubon are exhibiting neurological problems, like an inability to move. Something experts say is a telltale sign that they've been eating fish contaminated with red tide.
Sometimes people describe it as being almost like they're drunk or intoxicated, where they can't really walk straight. Maybe their head is wobbling.
As a bird biologist for SCCF, Audrey Albrecht has seen her fair share of sick seabirds. But lately, she's noticed a surge in birds poisoned by red tide.
Just kind of those unusual behaviors kind of indicate that something's going on, and often by the time we can catch them, they're unable to fly.
Those unusual behaviors she mentioned are a side effect of red tide that comes when birds eat contaminated fish.
And then when the fish start dying, some of the seabirds will still eat them, you know, because it's food right at the surface, and they just get a big dose of the toxin then.
It's called brevetoxin, according to Dr. Mike Parsons from FGCU. It's a neurotoxin that, when ingested, affects motor functions and can even cause death.
And so when you get a large enough dose, it can really start shutting down the nervous system, and then that can lead to illness and mortality.
An ailment that Audrey says wildlife hospitals are used to dealing with later on in the season, when migratory birds have already gone.
It's really heartbreaking, especially you know, I've seen this a lot in the past in the fall migrations when they come back from having nested, but this one kind of feels different because it's happening before they're migrating, so these birds need to fly a couple thousand miles.
An earlier effect that could cause a problem far from Southwest Florida. Reporting in Lee County, Alex Howard, NBC2.